the Etc. channel, and today we'll be using Crayola PaintMate. Let's get started.
Okay, so this is the Crayola PaintMaker unboxed and all set up. It did take a while and was kind of difficult to snap together, so kids, you might want some help from your parents. And it comes with a little handle, so it makes it really convenient to carry, and it folds all right up. And when you're ready to play with it, you just unsnap one of the handles and open it up.
Okay,
on this side we have little compartments to store your little paint containers. And on the other side we have the color strips and a place to hold your paintbrush, which comes in the set. And we also have, this is our base paint, and this goes right over here. So whenever you're ready to make a color, you just take one of the paint pots, place it in the little slot, and it also comes with a color chart. So it tells you what amount of each strips you need to make each color. So what color are we making today? Okay, we're gonna make this blue color right here. And for that, we need 5 blue strips, and yeah, just 5 blue strips. Okay, let's try orange. Okay, we're gonna make the color mixing example. This one on the bottom, that takes 3 yellow and 2 red.
Stickers to put on your paint.
Okay, so our first step is going to be filling the little compartment up with base paint. So there's a little fill line right there, and that's where you're going to want to fill up your little compartment with your base paint. There's the fill line. Okay. So Chad passed it by a lot. But that's okay, we'll just try and see how this turns out.
Fail.
Okay. So for the orange, we're gonna need 3 yellow, 2 red. Okay, so this is what the color strips look like. And then to use one, you break it off. There's one strip. And for this orange color, we're gonna need 3. There you go. Chad, so you're gonna wanna put those in the base paint. Do that for 30 seconds, and then you can open it up to take a look at the color, and if it needs more mixing, you just put it back in. Okay, and it still looks like our color strips are intact. You might want to use a paintbrush to push them down a little bit. Get in there. Oh, this stuff smells so bad. Okay, let's keep shaking.
She got on a plane,
and it looks like our color strips are pretty much dissolved. There's still some in there. That's okay. Let's add more yellow and a little bit more red. Someone overfilled it. This toy is very noisy, so. According to the instructions, it says to do that for around 30 seconds, but you definitely need longer than 30 seconds. It might just be easier to use your hand, to be honest. Okay, now let's go with our color. And the paint, I'm not sure if the paint strips are supposed to dissolve in there. It sounds like they are supposed to, but I don't think ours are dissolving. Maybe because we put too much paint in it. But we'll just keep going till they dissolve, I guess. Woo! keep going. Just by using the shaker. So what we did was we went ahead and opened it up and used the paintbrush to mix it in, and that worked just fine, and it was even faster. This is a little bit messy, so you might want to be careful. But yeah, it doesn't look like the color strips are supposed to be dissolving. So if you want, you can leave them in there, or you can take them out. But it's going to be a little bit messy. So the color we got is orange. Like we were hoping for. Okay, and that's basically how it works. And you can keep using the color chart to make other custom colors. This paint does not smell very nice. Just a warning. And that's basically the Crayola paint maker. Yeah, let's go ahead and label it. Write the color orange on it. Write on it first. You're gonna wanna write on the label first. Product looks like orange. And we'll go go ahead and make more colors for you so we can draw you a picture.